What is up, YouTube? Lou Boyer coming to you from Tokyo in Japan. I just got in this morning. As you can see, it's kind of a cloudy day here. It's high clouds and a pretty good chance of rain later in the day. So, you know, for us, that's snaky weather here. Temperature-wise, it's about 21 or 22 Celsius, which is about 70 on the Fahrenheit scale. And yeah, I'm wearing a yellow shirt. It's funny, when I packed for this trip, I didn't even know I owned a yellow shirt. I actually own more yellow cars than I own yellow shirts, but yeah, yellow shirt and all, let's go find some snakes. And you can see I've got kind of a strange combination with the long pants and the sandals, and that's because I've got to walk through all this. Guys ask me a lot of times if I worry about snakes with my sandals, and you know, if I really worried about it, I wouldn't be walking out here in sandals, but the odds on finding snakes, it's so hard that the odds on actually stepping on one, I think, would be, you know, I don't know, 1,000,000 to 1. Yeah, this place is just totally overgrown since I was here last time. I don't know if it's wet down here, or sometimes water runs right down through here. But it's looking relatively dry. Haven't found anything under this board yet this year. So maybe today will be the first snake under it. Or not.
It's always a bit of a disappointment when I don't find something underneath the first piece, because I know I can make the video if I find a snake right away, but I got a few more pieces.
Nope. So I've got a carpet here which is usually too wet. But, well, yeah, too wet. And my best piece is right here. Let's see, I've found 2 forest rat snakes here this year. It could be the same one twice, but I found it like 2 weeks apart. Will I find something today? Not under this piece. All right, bummer. This rock here seriously weighs about, I don't know, 30 or 40 pounds. Nothing under it. All right. Let's see here. centipede. I haven't seen one this year, but they'll be everywhere here in another month or so. I'm kind of lifting these gently because if there's a tiger keelback, he'll probably disappear right away. Speaking of tiger keelbacks, I've found 2 or 3 of them here underneath this piece this year. You know, to find another one would be great. I think you guys are going to probably get tired of seeing them at some point. But let's see, could be something different. Oh, there's 3 different types of snakes right here. The tiger keelback just took off over there. And look at this. Double flip on these. I'm gonna grab them both, actually, if I can. All right, so I managed to grab them both, and they've musked all over me, so I smell awful. They're both actually the same species, although one's gonna shed and one isn't. So I'll let the one that's going to shed go, and there he goes, and I'll take video of the other guy.
All right, so here we go. Here's the prettier of the two. It's a forester burrowing rat snake. Too bad the sun's not out. You guys could really see the colors on this thing. It's nice and orange, although it's just not showing up without the sunshine on it.
He's not very big, as you can see. He's probably, I don't know, 1.5 feet long, something like that. It's a good size comparison with my pinky behind it there. You can see the belly on them here just a little bit, real checkered. Another common name is a Japanese corn snake.
All right, it's actually starting to rain here. I don't know if you can see it. It's not raining too hard yet, but some pretty big drops starting to come down. So I'm gonna get out of here real quick and seek some shelter because I don't have anything to protect my camera. I'm gonna bring the snake with me and I'll take more video once the rain stops.
Yeah, the things I do. Made it back to the hotel, but as you can see, I got totally soaked. Now, luckily, I think my camera's still recording right now. I put that under my shirt, so I kept it relatively dry. I did bring the snake back as well, which I typically wouldn't do, but it's kind of a pretty snake, and I want to get some better video. So I'm going to shower and clean up real quick. I'll take some video, and then I'll take the snake back after. All right, so as you can see, still raining, and it's about 4 p.m. now. So, you know, there's a good chance it just won't stop raining today. Now, I am here all day tomorrow, so I'll probably just keep them in the room here at night. I'm sure there's some policy against that, but, you know, who's going to tell? And then I'll look tomorrow for some more snakes, if that's what I do. I'll keep a camera to the sky here and see what happens. All right, so morning day two. Started off a little bit foggy, but the sun is out now. It's beautiful. I've got the snake here. I'm gonna take a little video and then I'm gonna release him where I found him. Yeah, I sort of borrowed a pillowcase from the hotel to hold him overnight. Hopefully they won't mind, or no. It's cool the little swaying they do. I've seen that in a couple different rat snakes. So put some music to that, huh? Go, 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 shawty, it's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip a Cardi like it's your birthday. All right, here he is. I'll put him on the road. There's no traffic here. And hopefully he'll stay still for at least a little while. All right, well, that's not really working out too well, but I know this video's not very good either. I'm gonna have to come up with something here. I'm not really sure what I'm gonna do, but this isn't working. All right, so I'm actually gonna move him into the shade. I've already tried it here in the sun a couple times, and he's just too fired up. So we'll see if I can do it in the shade where it's a little bit cooler. All right, so maybe a little better here in the shade. And I don't even know how well this is gonna work out because he just won't stop moving. At some stage, I might have to just pick him up. But a forest rat snake, otherwise known as a burrowing rat snake, or the Japanese sometimes call it a Japanese corn snake. I'll put the scientific name down. The first, you know, part of it I might be able to pronounce. The second part actually sounds like a disease you caught from some, you know, well, let's just leave it at that. I'm not going to pronounce that one. These snakes are usually full grown, about a meter in length, 3 feet. This one's only about a foot. And the colors are usually brighter when they're little like this. They fade out as they get older. That said, when we flipped it yesterday, you know, there was another snake just like it right next to it, same species, that looked totally different. And that's most likely due to the fact it was in shed. But yeah, this one's a beauty, huh? So there is a little traffic on this road, as you can see, but it's not too bad. Hello. Hebby. Hebby. Yeah. Yeah. Pretty, huh? Segoy, yeah. All right, so I've worked for a Japanese airline for like 20 years. I can barely say a word of Japanese, but Hebby means snake. Segoy means cool. And yeah, cool snake, huh? Let's go put this cool snake back. All right, so this is the board I found him under. Remember, there were a couple other snakes under it. So I'm gonna put him on top and I'm gonna flip this again to see what it's under it. But you can see evidence of the rain here. But there he goes. They typically go back towards this rock pile back here because I think that's where they hibernate through the winter. Will there be another one under here today? No, nothing today. Oh, I take that back. There is, can you see that? I don't want to mess with him. That is a tiger keelback snake. Venomous as well as poisonous. And I didn't even see him at first. There's his head. I don't know how well this is turning out because I'm holding up the piece of tin and just kind of holding the camera. Oh, he went way over there. That was kind of cool. He actually went in this hole here, came out that one over there, and went in the grass over there. All right, guys, so just the one snake in this video. We actually saw three, but I really only got video of one. And, you know, I sort of feel bad for that, but to be honest, this spot out here to find one snake, especially that species, would be a great day. So, and it is a great day. That said, I know there's a lot of YouTube channels out there lately putting out, you know, 50 plus snakes, 100 plus snakes.
People rescuing rattlesnakes. I know all that gets most of the views, and that's fine. I just, you know, that's not going to happen out here. So I hope you liked it. I hope you liked just seeing that one snake, and I hope you stay tuned for some more videos. As always, guys, thanks for watching. Subscribe if you want to, and we'll see ya. Yeah, bonus footage time. I say that, I haven't flipped anything yet, but that piece there, that's where I released the snake yesterday and where I flipped those three snakes 2 days ago. Now, my flight's delayed by about 18 hours, so I'm still in Japan. I am wearing my lucky yellow shirt again, so maybe I'll have a triple flip again. I haven't looked yet, so we'll just find out together what's under here. But I'm guessing, you know, at least one of those snakes is going to be back. Maybe something different. There's a tiger keelback. And that might be about it. But that's pretty cool.